If you believe a kernel is that odd thing inside a fruit, this video is for you. Okay, let's pretend today this picture is a representation of your computer. When looking at the fruit from the outside, the only visible part is the skin. This is what we call the user interface. Historically, user interfaces were text-based, with the users having to type and remember the actual commands required to perform some actions on their computer. Such interface is called a command line interface. Command line interface is still used today, mostly by advanced users, as it can be really powerful. But given the evolution of the hardware, graphical user interfaces have become prevalent today. Being much more intuitive and user-friendly, they did a lot for the adoption of computers by a large population. When you use your mouse to click on an icon or to choose a command in a menu, you are using a graphical user interface. But the user interface is only the visible part of your system. Behind that, there is a dense and thick part called the user land. This is the home of the processes. A process is nothing more than a program running on your computer, and you may have tens or hundreds of them running at the same time. Those programs can be large applications, or very small utilities, or even system software. Sometimes you may hear the word daemon in that context. This is just a fancy word to talk about a process waiting in the background to provide some service. Most important, processes can be divided into privileged and unprivileged processes. You know, security is a key feature of modern operating systems. Unprivileged processes are run by ordinary users and are subject to per-user permission verifications. On the other hand, privileged processes are processes run by a special user root, and they have that superpower of bypassing permission verifications. Please notice that processes are independent entities. In the sense, a process cannot randomly access or modify another process, even if it belongs to the same user. This is another security feature of modern operating systems. But who exactly is responsible for enforcing those security policies? This is the job of the kernel, the most central and deeply buried part of the operating system. The kernel has direct access to the hardware and is capable of doing whatever it wants on your computer. The core task of the kernel is to manage processes and provide them fair and secure access to the underlying hardware. For example, it's kernel responsibility to check permissions when a process tries to access a file, or to kill a process if it detects that later is using too much memory. What we traditionally call Linux is in fact the Linux kernel and a set of utilities on top of that. This is the Linux operating system. In that design, higher-level applications can rely on services provided by the operating system to properly handle user requests. In addition, layering has another advantage. You, as the user, you will not notice if some software has undergone profound changes as long as the user interface remains the same. For the same reasons, processes will not notice a change in the underlying hardware as long as the kernel is providing apparently identical services to them. So, each layer is responsible for providing a new abstraction layer, a key concept in modern computing. And this is the end of our story today. I hope this little video has clarified some core concepts we use a lot when talking about Linux and more generally about computers. if something wasn't clear or if you want more details, don't hesitate to use the comment section below. I'm looking forward to reading you.